For news, views, trends in ICT globally and in Africa in particular, watch AIT Infotech Network for the latest news and innovation in ICT for development in Africa. Plus, what technology can do for you from business to politics, tourism and culture. I am Bayero Agabi. You're welcome.
The accelerated liberalization of the past decade has allowed the rapid growth of Nigeria's ICT sector. A telecoms penetration rate of more than 70% has been reached, up from 2% in 2002, with a mobile footprint covering most of the country. Internet users continues on an upward slide, with over 45 million Nigerians connected. On the global scene, the story is not different, as millions of applications are driving the numerous devices churned out by manufacturers, from smartphones to tablets and gaming devices. Communication has become at a speed of light. This quickly brings to mind the relevance of the traditional mailing system in today's digital world.
The advent of television has not obliterated the use of radio. So the advent of computer technology also has not obliterated the use of television. So it's going from one aspect of technology, whether it is the lowest stratum to highest. So you discover that the post will always be a civilization-propelled industry and industry that also propels civilization.
In the United States, which is home to some of the world's biggest tech companies, the post office has come under severe pressure. In the UK, the seeming dearth of the post office made the government to make serious commitments to save the system in 2010, providing about £1.34 billion to modernize the post office network and safeguard its future. Similarly, the Nigerian government recently moved the Nigerian Postal Service to the Ministry of Communication Technology for proper communication and integration into the demands of the new age. But generations that have grown in the internet age are seeing less and less utility in mail services as most offerings have moved online.
Personally, it's been a while because I can easily log on to the internet on my inbox and get all the documents I need or exchange correspondence with friends, family and even co-workers.
Yes, it's not often. I can remember the last time I made use of it was last month.
With such trouble for the postal system, the question is, what should it be doing next?
I think the first thing that we attract people to really pay attention to night post services is fast delivery of service. People want things to be done right on the spot. They want their message to get to the recipient, and from there they will be comparing what internet can offer them, or rather what the digital world can offer them.
I believe what they can do is that they should try to update the way and manner they operate their business.
Innovation, they say, makes the difference. Smart countries are innovating to ensure the post office remains relevant in today's digital world. A lot of post offices across the world now offer banking, mobile services, digital document handling, and online access, among others. In Nigeria, the story is not different, as IPOT says it's transiting from their existing model to the digital world.
Well, as far as NIPOST is concerned, the electronic-based services are just leveraging on what NIPOST has ever been doing, trying to abridge people in places within the possibility of the highest level of transportation mode. And electronic device today is a higher service of transporting messages from one place to another. On the basis of that, it is a dictum in the postal service that the highest level of technology should be incorporated into every aspect of the post. And as a result of that, today, you will see before we were using something like poster and money order, we have now translated and transformed into using what is called the post cash. We are also having a kind of relationship with the central bank, which is trying to ensure the appropriate use of the highest level of technology in what is called financial inclusion, which forms one of the cardinal principles of the Universal Postal Union.
Despite the challenges faced by the traditional mailing system, the post office, governments across the world see it as more than a commercial entity serving a distinct social purpose. So the post office must be protected and properly funded to meet up with the demands of the new age.